Hey guys, happy weekend. I usually don't upload any videos on the weekend because I'm a mom of two kids and I'm a very busy person. But because I've reached 400 subscribers this past few days, so I'm grateful to all of you that subscribed and took time to look at my videos. So this one is for you. I usually upload videos every fortnight, or I try to do it once a week. But this week I'm doing an extra video just for you. Hope you like it. This is sweet and simple stuff. But the colors are amazing, so I want to share this with you. Hope you guys enjoy this. I love Titanium Buff D by Amsterdam. So I use it a lot in my works, and I call this color a cookie dough color because I mix it with the dark umber. So you can see bits like chocolate chips on it, but it's actually dark umber from another cup that I mixed. So yeah, it's quite a sweet and nice calming color. So now I'm just gonna even it out to the sides, just using a spatula to spread the paints to the edges. I try to keep the paints on the canvas and not dripping down, because when that happens, they'll pull the paints down to the surface. So first thing, especially if you're doing detail pour, you'll definitely distort your image more. Especially for bigger paintings, you can definitely see the pool happening. Secondly, I don't like to waste paints, so I try to minimize as much spillage as possible to the surface. If you think your base has a lot of bubbles in the paint, so it's best for you to torch it first, because if you don't do that, you have a lot of tiny bubbles, tiny cells later, which sometimes can be nice. But for this piece, I try to minimize those tiny bubbles, so I'll just torch the base first. I've prepared four forefront colors, which are burnt umber. Can you see that it's a little bit liquidy? Because I want it to create some cells, so it's a bit runny. And then my second color is actually primary red mixed with gold, so it's a really luxurious color. You probably might not be able to see it here, but the color is gorgeous. And then the next color would just be gold. Just simple. So this is a bit thick, because I don't want to have a lot of cells for my gold. So I just made the paint a little bit thicker than usual. Lastly, to add this piece some really striking, beautiful, sweet color is Sky Blue by Amsterdam too. So now I've poured the four colors diagonally. Then I'm just going to do a Dutch pour, which is just to cover the paint with the base color and then blow it out. So this is to get a really light effect. If you don't want the colors to be too bright, then you need to blow over. But if you want the colors to be vivid, then you don't have to do this step by pouring paints at the sides. Now I'm going to blow the bottom half part downwards, and then the left side I'm just going to blow it upwards. For the upper part, I'm going to blow it upwards, the opposite direction from the bottom. The top upper part, I'm just going to do a big blow to it because I want the colors to bloom and to fill up the upper part of the canvas. Let's torch this to pop up all the bubbles.
Now I'm just going to blow certain parts with my mouth. I prefer to use my mouth over any other appliances or a straw because when you use the mouth, there's a soft touch to it compared to other types of blows. So yeah. Sometimes you use the straws or other appliances though. It doesn't mean it's a bad thing. It's just for this piece, I just want a softer flow to it. For the final step, I'm just going to touch up the edges. Thank you. Okay, I think we're done now, so I'm just going to take off the camera from the tripod to show you guys how it actually looks like from my angle. Just look at the colors, they're gorgeous. I love the warmth color, and I also love the hint of blue that brings out the I don't know how to call it, but it brings out a really nice vibrancy to the whole thing. So this is gorgeous. Thanks for watching. See you guys again, and thank you for subscribing once again. Thank you all. Bye.